Hello everyone, do you recognize the person you see on your screen? Yes, he is the great Thomas Edison. Do you know what he is known for? Yes, exactly, he is known for the invention of electric bulb. What do you all see on the screen? A night scenario, right? What is the most important thing that you can see in this image? Buildings, lights, roads, etc., right? You must be aware of the fact that lights works on electricity. I think you might have understood today's lesson, right? Yes, exactly. So today we shall study about electricity. In everyday life, you might have observed the working of different appliances in your home and outside, like television, air conditioner, heater, fans, electric bulbs, etc. They need electricity to function. So, electricity is the rate of flow of charges. Now, let's understand what constitutes the electricity. It is nothing but the electric charges. Electric charge is the basic property of matter carried by some elementary particles that governs how the particles are affected by an electric or magnetic fields. There are two types of electric charges. Positive electric charge and negative electric charge. Now let's understand what is electric current. Electric current is defined as the rate of flow of charge per unit time. We can also understand this as the amount of charge flowing per second through a conductor. To understand this, let us take a metallic conductor. Let us assume that some current is flowing through it. If I zoom in the particular portion, we can see that the charge is flowing in this cross section. If Q charge is flowing through the conductor in time t, then current I is given by I equal to Q upon t. It is nothing but charge upon time. And SI unit of electric current is ampere. And the direction of electric current is opposite to the direction of flow of electrons. And the path along which the electric current flows is known as electric circuit. But do you know what makes the charge flow or how does the electric current flow? Let us take a metallic conductor. In this conductor, there are electrons which are free to move. Do you think electricity will flow through it? Clearly not, because there is nothing that triggers it. So, what is the factor that triggers the flow of electricity? It is nothing but the potential difference. We know the word potential. It is nothing but the potential energy. That is the stored energy when an object is at rest. Similarly, there is a concept of electric potential energy. Can you tell me what is potential difference? Potential difference is the difference of electric pressure between the two points. It can be also defined as the work done to move a unit charge from one point to another. V equal to W upon Q. It is nothing but work done upon charge. And SI unit of potential difference is volt. Let us understand this concept by solving an example. In this example, we need to find the work done in moving a charge of 3 coulomb across the two points having a potential difference of 12 volts. We know that electric potential is equal to work done upon charge. We can find out work done as potential difference into charge. Potential difference given here is 12 volt and charge is 3 coulomb. If you multiply these two, we will get work done equal to 36 joules. Till now, we had understood the basics of electricity. Now, let us see the elements used in electrical supply. There are many elements that are used in electrical supply. And these are some components and their symbols. Now, tell me, is there any relation between electric potential and current? Okay, let's find out. Let us consider a circuit connection. We had taken a meter so as to measure the current that was flowing in the circuit and the voltmeter to know what is the potential difference across the ends. When we switch on the circuit,
the current will flow through it. And we can observe that voltage and current are directly proportional to each other. When we plot the graph of potential difference versus current, by taking the values from this experiment, we will get a straight line. Hence, we can say that the ratio of V is to I is always constant. This relation between voltage and current is given by George Ohm. According to Ohm's law, potential difference across the resistor is directly proportional to the current through it, provided temperature remains the same. That is, V is directly proportional to I. This implies V equal to IR, where R is the resistance. Resistance is the opposition to the current flows in a conductor. Now, let us solve an example. A potential difference between the terminals of an electric heater is 60 volt. When it draws a current 4 ampere from the source, what current will the heater draw if potential difference is increased by 120 volt? Potential difference given here is 60 volt and current is 4 ampere. According to Ohm's law, we have V equal to IR. This implies R equal to V upon I. On substituting the values, we will get R equal to 15 ohm. If the potential difference is increased by 120 volt, then again by applying the Ohm's law, we will get current I equal to 8 ampere. Now, can you tell me what are the factors on which resistance of a conductor depends? Resistance of a conductor depends upon the length of the wire L, cross-sectional area of the wire A, and also on the material of that conductor. Resistance of a wire is directly proportional to its length and is inversely proportional to its area. If we combine these two factors, we will get R is directly proportional to L upon A. If we remove the proportionality sign, then R equal to rho into L upon A, where rho is the resistivity of the material. It is the inherent property of the material and it does not depend upon the dimension of the wire. Now let's move on to our next concept, that is combination of resistors. We can use the combination of resistors in two ways. We can connect them either in series or in parallel. First, let us study about the series connection of resistors. In series connection, resistors are connected to end to end. That means one end of the resistor is connected to the second and so on. And the first end of the first resistor and the other end of the last resistors are connected to the terminals of the battery. In series connection, the electrons at one point will cross the resistors which are connected in series to reach the other point. Let us consider this circuit connection in which three resistors R1, R2 and R3 are connected in series and the current flowing through all the resistors is same. If the voltage across R1 is V1 and voltage across R2 is V2 and voltage across R3 is V3, then the total voltage is given by V equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Give it as equation number 1. By applying Ohm's law for R1, R2 and R3, we will get V1 equal to IR1, V2 equal to IR2 and V3 equal to IR3. Instead of these three resistors, if there was a single resistor R and the potential difference across this resistor is V, then according to Ohm's law, we will get V equal to IR. Give it as equation number 3. If we substitute equation 1 and 2 in 3 and on solving, we will get R equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3 and this is the equivalent resistance. Now let us solve an example. An electric lamp whose resistance is 30 ohm and a conductor of 5 ohm resistance are connected in series to the battery of 6 volt. Calculate the total resistance and current through it. Take R1 equal to 30 ohm and R2 equal to 5 ohm. Since the resistors are in series, the equivalent resistance R equal to R1 plus R2 and is equal to 35 ohm. To find the total current, apply the Ohm's law. We will get I equal to V upon R, that is equal to 0.22 ampere. Next one is parallel connection of resistors. When resistors are connected in parallel, then the electrons have the options to reach the point. We can say that the total current divides when the resistors are in parallel. Let us consider a circuit connection in which three resistors R1, R2 and R3 are connected in parallel. If the current across R1 is I1, current across R2 is I2 and current across R3 is I3, then the total current is given by I equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3, take it as equation number 1. And voltage across all the three resistors remains the same. Now by applying Ohm's law for R1, V equal to I1 R1, this implies I1 equal to V by R1. For R2, V equal to I2 R2, this implies I2 equal to V by R2. And for R3, V equal to I3 R3, this implies I3 equal to V by R3. Take it as equation number 2. Now, instead of three resistors, if there is a single resistor R, according to Ohm's law, I equal to V by R. Give it as equation number 3. On substituting equation 1 and 2 in 3 and on solving, we will get 1 by R equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. This is the equivalent resistance when three resistors are connected in parallel. Now, let us solve one problem. R1 equal to 10 ohm, R2 equal to 40 ohm and a 12 volt battery connected to an arrangement as shown in the figure. Calculate the total resistance. In this figure, two resistors R1 and R2 are connected in parallel. Then 1 by R equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. On solving, we will get 1 by R equal to 1 by 8. This implies R equal to 8 ohm. Okay students, have you all observed mobile phones or laptops getting heated up while charging so that you can touch and feel it? Yes, it is getting heated up, right? Do you know how this heat gets generated? This is called heating effect of electric current. If V is the potential applied and I is the current flowing through it for time t, then amount of heat generated in the conductor is given by H equal to V into I into T. Let's see Joule's law of heating. When current I passes through a conductor of resistance R for a time T, then heat developed is equal to the product of square of the current, resistance and time. It is given by H equal to I square RT. Now let's understand this concept by solving a problem. 100 joules of heat is produced each second in a 4 ohm resistance. Find the potential difference across the resistor. Here, heat produced H equal to 100 joules, R equal to 4 ohm and time t equal to 1 second. According to Joule's law of heating, we have H equal to I square RT. This implies I equal to square root of H upon RT. On solving, we will get I equal to 5 ampere. Then by applying Ohm's law, V equal to IR, we will get potential difference or voltage V equal to 20 volt. Well, we all know that generation of heat in a conductor is because of electric current flowing through it. We know that every appliance is linked with some or other resistance with it. In this way, electric energy is converted into heat energy. In many appliances, this heat energy goes as a waste. But in some appliances, this heat energy is useful. We know that almost every devices which we use work on electricity. Electric heating is used to produce light in an electric bulb. The filament of this electric bulb must retain most of the heat generated, so it becomes very hot to emit light. But this filament should not melt. Because of that, tungsten is used, whose melting point is extremely high. And the filament must be thermally isolated to ensure less loss of heat to the surrounding. For this purpose, it is filled with gases which are chemically inactive. Let's move on to our last part of this chapter, that is electric power. Electric power is defined as the rate at which electric energy is consumed in an electric circuit, and it is given by P equal to V into I.
SI unit of electric power is watt. Let us understand this concept by solving an example. In this example, we need to find an electric power. The voltage given here is 220 volt and current is 0.50 ampere. So we know that P equal to V into I. On multiplying these two factors, we will get electric power P equal to 110 watt.